Imagine you have an apple orchard farm. Before harvest, you want to know the taste of these apples. But how? Take a bite of each one of them? Absolutely not. I guess you would randomly pick several apples and judge the overall sweetness based on the taste of this. Wait a minute. Why these apples can represent the whole orchard? Because you are using the statistic method. Actually, we just go through a famous statistical investigation circle. Problem? Plan? Data? Analysis? Conclusion? And finally, communication. According to Wikipedia, statistics is the discipline that concerns the collection, organization, analysis, interpretation, and presentation of data. The well-planned statistical process allows us to have a peep of the overall picture from the sample. Such a useful tool, huh? Even better, it can help us foresee the future. Have you ever wondered where sport betting companies offering us comes from? Do you know they always win? Guess why? You are right. Statistics let us know the probability of the event. Please remember the certainty of that probability, even though the sample you observe shows randomness. The certainty of probability? Think that in the infinite parallel universes, 60% of them Team A will win the game, and that percentage won't change. Another example, say, there is a perfect even coin and you flip it over again and again for a very long time. You have a 50% chance of seeing the head and 50% chance of seeing the tail, although you can't tell next time whether it will show the head or tail, because it is random. Statistic and the probability is such a powerful tool for understanding our world. That's why, if you want to dig into the world of quantum computing, big data, machine learning, artificial intelligence, biomedical, gene editing, this list goes on and on. You definitely need this tool in your toolbox. By the way, you can consider the quantum fluctuation is the only randomness at this moment, like any other tool. If you want to release the full power of it, you have to learn how to use it first. Otherwise, the tool may do more harm than good. In our case, the conclusion we get from the statistics could be useless, or even worse, misleading. Say you want to know the ratio of big to small apple in your orchard farm. So you hired someone to randomly pick 500 apples. Among them, there are 418 big apples and 82 small apples. Then you're probably comfortable with the conclusion that the ratio of big to small apple is about 1/5. But how about only pick 5 apples and all of them happens to be big? Can you get the conclusion that all apples in your orchard farm are big? I'm afraid the answer is no. That seems obvious. Really? Let's see another example. 2016. There is a sadly fatal autopilot car accident. the company said in their statement. This is the first known autopilot dice in some 130 million miles driven by its customers. Among all vehicles in US, there is a fatality every 94 million miles. This statement is criticized by a lot of people because, think about that five apples we just talked about. Once upon a time, there was a supersonic aircraft named Concorde. Concorde can reach speed 2,179 kilometers per hour and was the safest aircraft all over the world. However, since supersonic airlines are relatively new and have far less recorded flight distance than traditional aircraft, after a crash, Concorde becomes the most unsafe aircraft and forced to retire in 2003. Do you think that fire? Enough the upset stories. Let me bring you a piece of good news. Unlike the brothers and sisters in the mathematics family, statistics won't require to remember tons of equations or do hard calculations, which means you can have the statistics superpower relatively quick. In the next few episodes, I will explain the backbone concept to help you understand statistics and probability theory and comfortably apply them to solve real-world problems. I'm always here at your service. See you in the next episode.